The story of the annexation of Crimea has deep-rooted links to the history of Ukraine and Russia, with the land being a divisive topic for both states for as long as they have existed. The current tensions can be linked to more recent context, however, with a key cause in this being the dissolution of the USSR in 1991. The dissolution of the Soviet Union marked a momentous transformation in world history, as well as a significant chapter in the emergence of independent nations from the once mighty superpower. Ukraine, the largest of the former Soviet republics, apart from Russia, played a pivotal role in these events. The late 1980s and early 1990s witnessed seismic changes in the USSR. The political and economic systems were unraveling, and a wave of political liberalization, known as glasnost, under Mikhail Gorbachev, opened the door for more freedom and democratic movements. In the backdrop of these developments, Ukraine's national identity and the desire for independence grew stronger. The Ukrainian national movement, driven by figures like Vyacheslav Chernobyl and Vyacheslav Kirilenko, gained momentum. The 1989 protests in Kiev's Independence Square served as a catalyst for these movements. On the 24th of August 1991, Ukraine declared its independence from the Soviet Union. This declaration of sovereignty was overwhelmingly endorsed by the Ukrainian people in a nationwide referendum later in December. In the aftermath, Leonid Kravchuk became Ukraine's first president. Ukraine's path to full independence was complex and challenging. Negotiations with Moscow, particularly under Boris Yeltsin, determined the nature of their relationship. Its sovereignty was cemented, and it emerged as an independent nation. Ukraine's early years of independence were marked by numerous challenges. The country had to navigate economic difficulties, political transitions, and societal shifts. Privatization, land reform, and democratization were key aspects of the transformation. Ukraine's unique situation included inheriting a significant portion of the Soviet Union's nuclear arsenal. Through the Budapest Memorandum, Ukraine agreed to disarm in exchange for security assurances from the US, Russia, and the UK. This was a crucial step that contributed to global non-proliferation efforts. Over the years, Ukraine's political landscape evolved, and various leaders shaped its path, including Leonid Kuchma, Viktor Yushchenko, and Viktor Yanukovych. Notably, the Orange Revolution in 2004 marked a significant moment of public protest and political change, resulting in a rerun of the presidential election. In the 2010s, Ukraine faced severe political and security challenges, such as the Euromaidan protests, which culminated in the ousting of President Viktor Yanukovych in February 2014, which ultimately led to the Russian annexation of Crimea. The Takeover. This political upheaval prompted Russia to take advantage of the situation, particularly in Crimea, where it had military bases and a majority ethnic Russian population. Russian troops, later dubbed Little Green Men, due to their unmarked uniforms, began infiltrating Crimea in late February 2014. These forces seized key strategic locations, including airports and government buildings. On February the 27th, 2014, armed men, believed to be Russian special forces, took control of the Crimean parliament and ousted the government. They replaced local authorities with pro-Russian officials. There was overall very little resistance from the Ukrainians due to the element of surprise and the overwhelming gulf in difference in class and sheer number of Russian forces. In total, the Russians lost one Crimean SDF trooper, with the Ukrainians suffering 2 soldiers killed, 60 to 80 soldiers detained, and worryingly, 9,268 military servicemen and 7,050 civilian employees defected. In a disputed referendum held on March the 16th, 2014, Crimea's population voted to join Russia. However, the vote took place under the presence of Russian military forces, and it lacked international recognition as a free and fair ballot. After the referendum, Russian forces surrounded Ukrainian military bases in Crimea, forcing the withdrawal of Ukrainian troops. This marked a de facto military occupation of the peninsula by Russia. Despite widespread international condemnation, Russia moved swiftly to recognise Crimea's independence and formally annexed it on the 18th of March 2014. This led to a significant deterioration in Russia's relations with the West. In response to Russia's actions, Western countries, including the United States and the European Union, imposed sanctions on Russian individuals and entities, isolating Russia diplomatically. The Ukrainian government did not formally cede Crimea and viewed the annexation as a violation of its territorial integrity. This event further fueled the ongoing conflict in eastern Ukraine, particularly in the Donetsk and Luhansk regions. The annexation of Crimea by Russia was met with widespread condemnation. The United Nations General Assembly passed a non-binding resolution affirming Ukraine's territorial integrity. However, Russia vetoed a United Nations Security Council resolution that aimed to declare the referendum invalid. The G7 countries, previously the G8 with Russia's inclusion, suspended Russia's participation in the group, and discussions about Russia's territorial acquisition became more strained. The annexation had long-term implications for the geopolitical balance in Europe, contributing to NATO's increased presence in Eastern Europe, and an overall shift in relations between Russia and the West. Current situation. This incident reshaped the geopolitical landscape of Eastern Europe and triggered ongoing tensions between Russia and the West. The aftermath of this controversial event has left Crimea in a complex and unresolved status, with significant consequences for both the region and international relations. As of today, Crimea remains under de facto Russian control, with the Russian authorities governing the region. The Russian government has invested heavily in infrastructure development, including the construction of the Kerch Bridge connecting Crimea to the Russian mainland. Human rights organisations have reported political repression, including the targeting of Crimean Tatars, a significant ethnic group in the region. Many Crimean Tatars oppose the annexation and have faced discrimination, persecution, and arrests. While the region's economy benefits from Russian investment, it is also heavily dependent on subsidies from the Russian government. Crimea's integration into the Russian economy has brought some economic development, but also challenges related to sustainability. The international community, including Ukraine and the majority of the world's nations, continues to consider Crimea as a part of Ukraine. The United Nations has maintained its stance on Crimea's status, emphasizing Ukraine's territorial integrity. The annexation of Crimea led to a significant shift in the geopolitical balance in Eastern Europe. NATO increased its presence in Eastern Europe in response to perceived Russian aggression, and tensions between Russia and Western countries, particularly the United States, persist. The legal status of Crimea remains a subject of debate. While Russia insists on its sovereignty over the region, the majority of the world does not recognize the legitimacy of the annexation, creating a lasting legal and political conundrum. The annexation of Crimea had far-reaching consequences for international relations. It fueled a resurgence of tensions between Russia and the West, leading to diplomatic confrontations and sanctions. It also underscored the challenges associated with territorial disputes in the 21st century. The future of Crimea remains uncertain. While Russia shows no sign of relinquishing control, the international community continues to assert Ukraine's sovereignty over the region. This enduring conflict in the heart of Europe has hindered prospects for regional stability and normalized tensions between Russia and Western powers. It is widely known Russia launched a full-scale invasion of Ukraine in 2022, and as part of this, used the occupied territory of Crimea to help facilitate the invasion. Due to the high presence of military hardware and logistical supply for the Russians in Crimea, it has become a target for the Ukrainians, with the Kerch Bridge and harbour at Sevastopol being struck, among other locations. It has also been a key goal for the Ukrainians to recapture the peninsula as a part of their ongoing fight for liberation. In conclusion, the aftermath of the 2014 annexation of Crimea has left the region in a complex and contentious state. Russia's control over Crimea and the ongoing conflict in eastern Ukraine continues to shape international relations and highlight the difficulties of resolving territorial disputes in a globalized world. The situation in Crimea remains a sensitive and unresolved issue that reverberates throughout the region and the broader international community. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, then please give it a like. And for more amazing tales and thrilling stories, don't forget to subscribe to Uncovered Secrets. Also, hit the bell icon to stay notified for every release.